Today's tutorial will be on international trade. We will continue our discussion with regard to balance of payment. Now, in our last tutorial, I'll help you and we together have actually determined the value of foreign trade multiplier. Now, we can easily depict this foreign trade multiplier. That means the graphical representation of this multiplier, which we are gonna today. So today's objective is to show the graphical representation of this. So let's get started. So first I'll be drawing two axes. So on the horizontal axis, I'm measuring the national income. I'll go very slow so that it becomes easy for you to understand. And then on the vertical axis, I'll be measuring three things. What are these three things? Let us write. So first is savings. Then we have exports. And lastly, I'll measure imports. Don't worry about investment. I'll tell you the assumptions that we will undertake. So it will take care of that. Now, first we will draw the S plus M, which is the savings plus import function curve. We will draw it. So first let us draw this. So say it looks something like this. Okay. So this is our S plus M. Now, after this, we will consider the export. So I'll mark XO as the export curve. And we will make certain assumptions. Well, assumption here will be, it will be constant. And it is assumed to be autonomous. And autonomous variable. Autonomous variable means it is fixed, it is exogenously given, that is, it becomes independent. So it gets independent of level of income. So let us draw this export curve also. So I have to mark it using X0. So X0. So this is our export curve. Okay. Now, further to simplify the analysis more, we assume that there is no investment. And that's why we haven't written investment on the vertical axis. An equilibrium level of income, a national income, will be therefore determined by consumption mirror image savings and our exports. Okay, so let us begin. Now they are getting intersected at, say I'll mark this point as E0. Okay. Now let us see the initially what is the situation. So initially the economy is in equilibrium. And where is this equilibrium? At the level of income. So let us mark it Y0 at level of income. Y0. What is happening at Y0, or what is so special, where this S plus M function is equal to X0 and our investment is being zero. Now this is the initial situation. Now we will make some changes, alterations. So suppose there is an autonomous increase in export. So what happens, given this, the export curve will get affected. So export curve is affected. Given there is an increase in the export, it will shifts upwards. So let us shift the export curve upwards. So again, we have to draw a parallel line. Okay. And this is, I'll mark it as X1. This point as E1. This measures the change in X. And this measures the change in Y. This is the new equilibrium, Y1. And I'm indicating by the arrow that it has been shifted upwards. Okay. So let us write this. So we have, it shifts upwards and it is shifting from X0 to, okay, I have to mark it. I've marked it both as X0. So say this is X1 to X1. Okay, and you can see it clearly that the equilibrium income increases to Y1. Okay, so the increase in export by delta X has led to an increase in income by delta Y, which is equal to Y1 minus Y0, and which is much greater than change in export. So what I'm trying to say is that if you can see that this expression of delta Y, which is measured horizontally, and the expression delta X, and if you compare it just by looking at a glance, you can say change in delta Y is more than change in delta X, isn't it? So here we have, so the expression given by delta Y by delta X is nothing but represents or captures the foreign trade multiplier, whose value actually depends on, which is very important, on the slope of savings import function curve, which is given to be S plus M, which is actually equal to the reciprocal of the sum of marginal propensity to save and marginal propensity to invest. And whatever I have written, imports, I'm so sorry, here symbolically it is given by 1 by S plus M, where this first one is the marginal propensity to save and this is to import. And this is how you derive it. Now, the next question working in your mind is how this multiplier is actually working. Why this figure of delta Y is actually greater than delta X? It should have been equal. It should have been this case also. But why it is this case? Why is it, because we have drawn the figures to, and that's why it is like this? What happened if we have drawn it another way? Why this is only the correct form? So there is a lot of questions in the mind. Now, when we were doing simple Keynesian model, or our SKM, we had talked about the multiplier effect. And this foreign trade multiplier has a similar explanation, or the working behind this foreign trade multiplier is the same way as Keynes investment multiplier. So in our next tutorial, this will be the job, and we will be discussing in details how this multiplier is actually working.